Hi everyone, I'm Izzy from Vevox and I'll be running through with you today how to use Vevox as a participant. To join a Vevox session, you will need to go to vevox.app in a web browser, so either on your phone, a tablet or a laptop. So when you get to this page to log in, you will need to enter a session ID that is provided by the presenter. And once you have entered that, hit join. And this will take you through to the main app. So as you can see on the left-hand side here, it says anonymous, so meaning any results, anything I post through the Q&A board, it will all be anonymous. No one will know that that is me. But if you were identified, it will say so on the left-hand side here. And when you log in, you will also need to enter your first name and last name. So through Vevox, we have our polling, our Q&A board and our survey feature. So first of all, I'll run through the polling and then we'll go through the two other features in a second. So when a presenter is ready to ask you their questions, they will open up their first poll and it will look a lot like this. Perfect. So the first question comes up. So this is a multiple choice and it has our question at the top. So which country is the largest in the world by surface area? As a participant, I will just need to click on the answer that I think it is. And then once all of the votes have been received by the presenter, they will then close the poll and the results will be displayed like so. As the question has a correct answer set, the presenter would then display the answer that is correct and it would look like that. If they are then ready to go on to the next question, they will then just simply click next poll. And we can see now that we have a new question that has appeared. So this is a word cloud, a nice simple question. So how are you feeling today? As the participant, I will just need to come in here and enter my responses. For a word cloud, you are only able to send in one-worded answers, but there is no limit as to how many one-worded answers you are able to send in. You can send in as many as long as the poll is still open by the presenter. But once they close that poll, the results will also then be displayed on my screen for me to see the final word cloud. Perfect. So again, as I mentioned, if the presenter then has more questions, they'll simply just click next poll. But if not, I can go to the Q&A board. So if I have any questions or comments I want to post for the presenter and for everyone else to see, I will come through to this speech bubble tab at the top. And I can see here we've already got some questions sent in by other participants who are also logged into this Vevox session. So at the top here, we have our box to ask a question. So I can say something like, please repeat last question. And I can just enter that and that will be automatically sent through to the Q&A board. I can like questions sent in by others by simply just clicking on this thumbs up icon on the right. I can also sort my Q&A board by most liked or most recent. So we can see here it changes the order, but whatever works best for you, both the options are there for you. I can see here at the bottom there is a message from the host, so from the presenter. It will be obvious as it says host in a big blue bubble. So this is a message from the presenter, so any information that they'd like to send you, they can post through there. Again, there's no limit on how many questions you can send in through a Vevox session. As long as it is all open by the presenter, you can ask as many questions as you need. And finally, the last feature of Vevox is the survey feature. So through the clipboard icon on the right hand side here. So when a survey is started by the presenter, you will see this clipboard icon. Whereas now, if there is no survey, I will only see these first two tabs here. So I can go through and give my answers to my surveys. And once I get down to the bottom, it will then tell me to submit all of my answers. And down the bottom here, 6 out of 6 answers, submit. And then that is all done. So I can go in at any point and I can edit my answers, but it does let me know that that survey is completed. Cool, thanks a lot for watching. If you have any questions, please get in touch with us at support@vevox.com.